Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can print this pattern. So in this pattern, you can see at diagonal position we have 1 and remaining positions are 0. So before starting, if you go to detail or description of this video, you will find links of various playlists. Those are related to my YouTube channel. So you can open them and watch various programming related videos. So now I am going to start solution of this pattern. So this pattern will be implemented with the help of nested loop. So we need to implement 2 loops. One will be controlling the rows. So here you can see we have 5 rows. So row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, and row 5. So when will be on row number 1? So here you can see we have 5 columns. So row 1 will print 5 elements, row 2 will print 5 elements, and so on. So column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4, and column 5. And this is a square matrix where number of rows and columns are same. So if we have square matrix, then only we have diagonal. So rows and columns will be same, then only you can print this diagonal as 1. So now I'm going to implement first loop. So it is starting from 1, condition is I less than 5, and then I plus plus, right? So this loop will repeat 5 times. Inside this loop, when it will be repeating 1 time. So inside this loop, I'm going to implement 1 more loop, which will start from 1 also, repeat 5 times. So this is inner loop, right? So this one is outer loop, and this is inner loop, right? Now inside this inner loop, I am going to apply if I double equals to j. So when I and j both are equal, it means I is representing row number and j is representing column number. So if both are same, let's say R1, C1, if they are same, we need to print. Then R2, C2, if they are same, then we need to print 1. So whenever value of row and column is same, then only we need to print 1, otherwise 0. So if it is true, then inside printf double quotes, you can print 1. Else, you can print 0. Right? And then you can close this inner for loop. After closing this, you need to print new line character as backslash n, and then you can close outer loop. So this way the solution of this pattern is implemented. Now I am explaining its rotation so that you will understand it clearly. So first it will start, so I will be 1. Now check the condition of I, it is true, then control will be transferred to this inner loop. So when control is here with j, so j will again start with 1 and it will repeat 5 times. So 5 times this if condition will be checked, 1 time it will be true and remaining time it will be false. So j is starting from 1. Now see, I and j both are equal, so 1 will be printed, it means this value is printed. Now j will be incremented, so j is now 2. So see, when value of I is 1, so j is repeating completely 5 times. So j is 2. Again check this if condition. So it is true or false? It is false, because I is 1 and j is 2. So this time else part will print 0. So this 0 will be printed. Again j will be incremented. So this time it is true. Sorry, this time it is 3. So again condition is false. So it will print 0. Then j will be 4. Again condition is false. So it will print 0. Then j will be incremented to 5. Again condition is false. So 0 will be printed. Then again j will be incremented. So this time you will see this condition is false. So when j is 5, so it is true. When j becomes 6, so it is false. So we will come out from this loop and new line character will be printed, so that we can print this second row. After this, I will be incremented. So this time I will be 2. Again control will be transferred here. So j will be reinitialized by 1, and again this time it will repeat 5 times. So first time you can see I is 2 and J is 1. So if is false, so 0 will be printed. Then J will be incremented to 2. So this time I and J both are same. So it will print 1. And then remaining 3 zeros will be printed because I is 2 and J will be 3, 4 and 5. So this way remaining digits will be printed. And if we see when I is repeating one time, I is repeating one time, it means when I is performing one rotation, so J is performing 5 rotation, right? So for I 1, J is repeating 5 times. So if I is repeating 5 times, then J is repeating 25 times, right? So that's why these digits are printed, and at diagonal position, we are able to print 1 and remaining we are able to print 0. And you can change it as well. If you want to print 0 on diagonal, so you can put a 0 here and a 1 here, so that diagonal is 0 and remaining 1 will be printed. So I hope you understood how this pattern can be printed with the help of nested loop. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel and go to playlist. There you will find various programming related videos. So do watch them. And thank you for watching this video.